From this section, we're going to create the material for our chair model. First, we're going to create a black painted metal, like the one we have in our photo reference we downloaded before. Also, if you look at one of my rendering, I actually modeled this chair a long time ago back in 2008 for this apartment project in Shanghai. Although the chair is way back behind all of this living room furniture, you still can see the legs and they are actually black painted metal. As we mentioned in the previous video, we're going to use Corona Renderer to handle material and lighting, so if you haven't used it, just download it first. I provide the link at the bottom of the video. It's free for 45 days and you can even use it for commercial projects in that period of time. On to the material. Open Material Editor and change the material type to Corona Material. Name the material Black Metal. And change the color to Near Black Color. Round value of 5 will do. For the record, I'm using Gamma 2.2. If you find my color different from yours, just go to Customize, Preference, and Gamma and LUT. Make sure the gamma is set to 2.2. I'm not going to discuss this in details of why I'm choosing that gamma value, as a lot of other tutorials already explain about that. Just Google the term of linear workflow. Okay, for the material to behave like a painted metal, we need to add subtle reflection on it. So to add reflection, increase the reflection level in here to about 0.5. Then increase the IOR to be about 2. And then to make the reflection appears a bit blurry, reduce the glossiness to about 0.7. Click drag this material to our chair model. So now we have something like this. Next, we want to create a black rubber material. This material is for the rotational hinge area in here, and also the rubber feet. We're not going to make it from scratch. Instead, we will copy the metal material that we already have by click and drag this to a new slot. Rename it to black rubber. And make the color pure black. Set the reflection level to only 0.1, IOR to 1.5, and glossiness to 0.1. Okay, now go to polygon mode. Select this one polygon and hold shift and click this one again so all of these polygons loop are selected. Click this assign material to selection button. Next, go to element mode and select the 4 rubber feet and assign the material also. For the seat, we're going to create a leather material. So create a new Corona material, name it leather brown. And go to the diffuse color map and add bitmap. Choose the leather image that we downloaded from the B&B Italia site before. Turn on show shaded material in viewport toggle button in here so we can see the texture in the viewport. Now select the entire element of the seat and hit the assign button. Notice the texture is not showing up. This is because we need UVW map to display images correctly in a 3D model. Again, if this basic concept is confusing you, please watch the last video of this playlist where I provide a link to a step-by-step 3ds Max course for beginners. Okay, let's add UVW map modifier and just set this to box and set the dimension to 100 by 100 and 100 centimeters. For complex shape furniture, using UVW map modifier will not be enough, as we will need more advanced UV mapping using unwrap modifier. But that's for another video tutorial. For now, box UVW mapping will be enough. Okay, notice how this leather texture looks very large in scale. Now, we can readjust the length, width, and height of the UVW map. But I'm going to show you different way to adjust this. Again, this is just to demonstrate the tiling feature of texture inside material. Go back to Material Editor and notice this tiling value. When this is set to 1, it means for every 1 unit of UVW map size, which is a box in our case, there will be 1 image projected. If we increase this value, we will have more images fit in, thus making the texture size scale down. Now, the correct size will be about 10 tiling. But sometime, when we're doing visualization, we need to make the texture more readable to the viewer, as this will communicate design preferences better. Especially when our 3D model is so far away from the camera, so I will make the tiling about 8. Now it looks a bit bigger from the real size and should be more readable to the eyes. Okay, now the diffuse is finished. Let's add a texture to control the reflection. Choose bitmap and choose the leather bump file that we downloaded before. Turn on the map in the viewport. And for this, I think I'm going to increase the tiling to around 5. Go back to parent material, set the reflection level to 1, IOR to 1.5, and the glossiness to 0.5. For the bump, just scroll all the way to the map section and drag this leather bump bitmap from reflection to bump map slot and choose instant. Then reduce the bump value to 0.2. Until now, you might be wondering, how do I know these numbers of hand? Well, I don't. I know it because I had a process of try and error before I even created this video tutorial. I don't want to waste your time seeing me doing the try and error process in the video. That is why I'm just throwing you the numbers I have tested before. If you want to master this, then you should try changing and experiment with these values later, okay? Next, we're going to create a studio-based lighting to render and showcase our chair model.